around the world with MS World. Here at the European Neurological Society meeting, I'm Dr. Daniel Kantor, president of the Florida Society of Neurology, standing in front of a poster that has to do not with people with MS, but has to do with an animal model called the Cuprizone model of multiple sclerosis. What they found is actually that there are different levels of a hormone called prolactin. And it looks like prolactin may actually be protective in multiple sclerosis, just like it's protective in this animal model. This may be partially why people with MS who get pregnant actually have a better time of their multiple sclerosis. We need to understand more about prolactin in MS, and we do have a lab test to check for prolactin levels. The question is whether that can be helpful in the day-to-day treatment of people with multiple sclerosis or not. But for now, this gives us just yet another insight into some of the hormonal effects and some of the growth hormone effects that happen in multiple sclerosis. So stay tuned, and stay tuned often to hear more. Thank you for joining us.